ni nikao jingine.
I am reaching. I'm reaching, aren't I? Hi there, lovely humans. Welcome to the Whole Line Yes 2.0. My name is Jemuna Stila. I am the host and the creator of this lovely channel. If it's your very first time clicking on this, I want to officially welcome you to this good vibes only channel. But if you're a regular degular, you know, you're a day one, well, I'm wishing you nothing but blessings and good health and clear skin and money. I want to officially welcome you to the Diaspora Diaries. Okay, well, I am currently in America. Yeah, I still don't know how to act. I am currently living in a state called Arizona, and this trip has been a long, long time coming. Like, this was supposed to happen like way back in 2019, but God had other plans, so it's happening in 2022, and we're grateful. And yeah, okay, well, so let me tell you, like, I was planning on a whole vlogging shebang. Like, I was gonna bring you along with me from the parking all the way to landing and reuniting with our family, but guess what? Nobody told me how stressful traveling international is. Oh my God. Like, we knew it was gonna be like a lot, but yo, my siblings and I have this running joke where we say we have PTSD from flying, because yo, we were in transit for the much we could count from the air tickets. We were in transit for approximately 33 hours. Good Lord. Good Lord. Like, let me tell you, I swear down, every time I see a scene, I'm not like... Mimi niko traumatized. Like, every time I'm watching something and there's an airplane scene or like a plane pitas, I'm feeling... Because we were on a plane, on planes for so long, I don't even... Like, me, as at now... I need time off. Like, I need time off from flying, because that was quite a lot. I swear it may sound like I'm exaggerating, but you have to go through it for you to understand. I don't care how much you think you enjoy planes and flying and whatever. Mm-mm. It was not cute. Like, we were not the passenger princesses we thought we would be. But at least our outfits are cute. So, hey. Yeah. All right. So, because I didn't get to do, like, a whole vlogging shebang, I did get some clips together of how the entire journey went. So just in case you want to know what that experience was like, just stay tuned and then you'll see just a couple of snippets from what the journey was like. So basically, when I say 33 hours, we flew from Nairobi to Doha, Qatar. Then from Doha, we flew to New York. Then from New York, we flew to Phoenix, Arizona. Yeah, and then from there, we were picked up. Then we came to the specific place we're in now. Let me tell you, flying from... Personally, I've never gone international. Like, the farthest I've gone, guys, is in... the farthest I've been to in Arusha. At the end on a bus. And then we were meant, it was good vibes. We drove, it was like a 5-6 hour drive. Yeah, by the way, if you ever think to do a road trip with your friends, like, it's literally that close. Who would have guessed? That's the farthest I'd gone. My siblings have flown international, but they were kids. They're like, these guys were in primary school and they flew with the school and teachers and whatever. So, like, all three of us had never flown as adults internationally. Ay, ay, ay. It's like, whew. Like, I was imagining, if this is what this feels like, I can only imagine what guys were going through when they were flying during COVID. Because, like, the amount of paperwork you have to keep preparing yourself for in advance, like, you have to make sure you have everything on point, you know. But, yeah. So, the flight from Nairobi to Doha was quite nice. Like, it was all right. It was 5 to 6 hours. It's just that the check-in process was quite long. Woo! Measuring your stuff, because now zinatumwa ahead, and then you're getting your boarding passes for every single step you're going through. Lord, it was quite a lot. Then they measure, we found out we misread the guidelines of the plane. We thought we were only allowed to carry 2 luggages each, but apparently it was 1 each, so we had to pay the extra. We paid a lot of money, guys. We paid about 60,000 Kenya shillings. But yeah, because now at this point, it's not like, it's a lot of luggage to leave, you know. Plus, you've already put your things together, so you can't just start shuffling. If it was an extra suitcase, fine. You'd have paid for it or probably taken it back because our family was still there. But hey, it was quite a lot. Anyway, the flight to Doha was quite nice. I think 80% of the people on that plane were Kenyans. Also, because of World Cup, I think a lot of young people are who have work on a kazi uko. So, yeah. It was interesting. And then, kufika, like most of the security personnel, like a lot of people that were helping us, you could just, uluko na soma tagu kia na jina Kenya, like, ani aji. Then you literally see these people easing up. Ay, familiarity is underrated. So, when you, if you can't, like, if you can't, like, say something, just flash your international visa. Shout out to my friend Eugene, he likes to call it the international visa. Yeah. But the ghetto, y'all, the ghetto. The ghetto was from Qatar to New York. So from what the etiquette said, when you were flying 9 hours, we were mentally prepared for a long flight. Kufika kwa airplane, imeandikwa 13 hours, 57 minutes. This someone at the door, give me a second. Well, while we're on this commercial break, let me show you how beautiful the airport at Doha was. Yes, like I said, then so technically that whole thing, let's just say it was approximately 15 hours because of course there's a boarding process, then the flight was, it was a bigger flight, but like was full kabisa because there was a couple of empty seats, and then of course could board, could talk, yo, let me tell you, I had leg cramps, I had numbness, I had, on top of things, this is TMI, but so I'm cramping on my legs, I'm cramping on my stomach, I'm just like, I'm over this shit. Then the worst part is, because New York was a fast entry point, you know, you're landing and you have to deal with customs immediately. Woo! I'm just prepping for anyone of us to fly international. The thing about us as Kenyans, Kenya is considered a high-risk country. Why it is, you're not, I don't even want to get into that. So most of the time, you may be selected to be screened by security specifically. The good thing is that they were very kind. Like, they dealt with it very in a very kind manner. But, like, my God. I don't want to get into it, but it wasn't cute. So, yeah, but then we've landed in New York safely. Getting through airport security, it was such a lot. You never realize how long it is. But thankfully, went through getting through customs, you just are like, dear Lord Jesus, don't let them ship me back. I promise my documents I can check. Yeah, and then at least we got through that like successfully. Hey, you guys, like the minute we can't like that, to connect like internet, to charge Masimu. Like we were literally just calling the farm, then everyone is telling everyone they're okay, they're okay, they're okay, they're okay, because woo! Yeah, I think that's basically it. Then from New York to Phoenix was just but at home, kanyanga in that soil, whatever your entry point is, you're good to go. But yeah, so without further ado, gosh, I've already talked too much. This is a bit of a vlog of what that journey was like getting till here where we are now.
All right, so I take that back. So since we already saw the other footage, this is basically the journey from New York to Phoenix.
Yo, we made it.
We made it at the hood.
We'll be right back. this one that's in the middle.
This brother, yeah?
Yeah.
Exactly, am I doing in America? Well, I am here for a couple of months because I'm here on a B1 B2 visa. That's basically the tourist travel visa. And thankfully, I'm so grateful. I have family here, like we have nuclear family here. Let me tell you, like, the next step in my life is literally just like Jesus take the wheel, like God just take the wheel, because there are a couple of things I want to achieve in life, and so to say, I think most of them could be achieved here, but that's only if God's favor allows, to be honest. Like, I don't have anything else to say to it, but apa ni Mungu tu. Like Carrie Underwood said, is it Carrie Underwood? Like she said,
Jesus take the wheel.
Yeah, so apart from that, like, what should be expected of me on this channel? Honestly, I don't know what reason for subscribing to this channel was. I don't know if you subscribe because you like the kind of conversations we usually have here. Maybe you subscribe because you like the vlog kind of content that I tried to do. I'm putting vlog because the consistency is a struggle. But I think moving on forward, because like I'm not able to do the conversations the way I used to, panel discussions and stuff like that, I will honestly just vlog. So because I want to experience this, I want to experience this experience to the fullest. Of course, there are certain things I'll be like, nah, let me not pick up the camera, let me not carry the camera. But other experiences, I'll be like, yo, let me take someone with me, someone who has a dream of coming here, or someone who wants to have any other. Who just wants to see another continent through someone's lenses, you're very much welcome. Because that's basically what you're about to see for like the next couple of weeks, months, basically. Yeah. So if you have any questions, honestly, regarding traveling and visa and whatever, Miss G, I'm not sure if I'm the best person to help. But having gone through it, and everyone's experience is different, of course. And there are certain privileges that I may have or someone else may have that we may not see eye to eye on. But I think I would be able to help. So you may send me a DM at @Monet_joy. I'm going to be nice. I'm going to respond to your DM. If you have my number, hit me up. Now I may share change, but like... WhatsApp. I may still have the Kenya number on WhatsApp. Yes, I don't think I have any other thing. Yes, so I want to start this cute little series called Diaspora Diaries on Instagram, though, like on the whole 9 years Instagram page, where I literally show you things that are just, it's either a yay or a no. Yes, yay or no. Like, I'm like, so this is how this and this works here. You think that's a yes or a no? A yay or a no? You get what I mean? Or yay or nay, Jesus. Come by my GD. But yay or nay, kind of thing. Yeah, because there are so many, like, let me not even get too much into, but these, like, cute little things that are just different from the sockets, the plugins, from the, yeah. So it'd be nice just to document that and we see if we're roasting them or we're just praising them for whatever it is, invention they have. Yeah, so that's basically it. Thank you so much for staying on board for, like, this 15 minutes or so of this vlog. And I will see you in the next couple of vlogs. Actually, the next vlog is ready. Like, we already did whatever. We already went. There's like a place we're going. It's called Set Downer. It was so pretty. Oh my God. Arizona is such a pretty state. But like, it's not LA, New York kind of. It's like fast paced and whatever. But it's like a more of a residential area kind of thing. Yeah. It's currently winter here. But then Arizona is a very hot state. So, kunatu baridi. Like, the sun is out. It's shining. But like, it's hella cold. But yeah. It's too much information. So I will see you on the next one. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. Natuendelee tu kuwa na good vibes and good vibes only. Bye.